Kelp is a large brown seaweed that creates three-dimensional habitats underwater. They grow very, very fast, and they produce a lot of biomass very rapidly that provides a large food source for these associated species. The Great Southern Reef is special for a number of reasons. It is a very extensive marine ecosystem that is essentially dominated by one species, the common golden kelp, Eclonia radiata. And we're trying to understand how the reef responds to pressure, such as climate change. In 2011, Western Australia experienced an extreme marine heatwave, which still is one of the most intense marine heatwaves that have been recorded anywhere in the world. And that heatwave lasted for something like 8 to 10 weeks and had devastating impacts across the marine environment. For instance, we lost 100 kilometers of kelp forests. After some time, we saw that this marine ecosystem wasn't recovering, and it looks like that may not happen unless we give them a helping hand. Green gravel is a relatively new technique for restoring kelp forests that we have been instrumental in developing. It is small rocks seeded with small kelp plants that you can scatter from a boat. Traditional methods have largely relied on scuba divers taking individual plants down and actually nailing them to the reef. But coming up with this green gravel technique has meant that it is now possible to seed large areas in one hit. The green gravel work that we've been pioneering has gone global, so we now are leading a green gravel action group. At the moment, I think we have 15 projects globally on 4 continents. We have started to use it in the field at relatively small scale so far, but we've had promising results, and we are hoping that in the coming year, we will upscale it to try and restore kelp forest at a scale that actually matters for restoration efforts. Now, we are mostly interested in the conservation side of things, but we work with kelp farmers as well to maybe try and generate also some alternative revenue streams for them. For instance, you can imagine that a kelp farmer doesn't just produce kelp for biomass, but a kelp farmer also produces green gravel for restoration. So if a community group could go to the local kelp farmer and buy locally produced green gravel to scatter on the local reef, it creates those pathways that enable the large scale restoration without the involvement of academics, because if we are going to make kelp forest restoration scalable and make it happen at a scale that matters for the overall restoration effort that is needed, it absolutely needs to leave academia and small-scale experiments and need to become a big, broad-scale, community-wide enterprise.